Now then, today in the box is the ZooZee Z50 robot vacuum cleaner. Let's give it a try.
Have a look and see what we got in the box. And this is the user guide and various bits and pieces of documentation, all very nicely printed, nicely presented. I just wish every company would give user guides as good. Now what's in here? No, nothing. Nothing in there, I don't think. So let's throw it away. Now here's the Z50 itself, which feels nice and substantial. It feels like a weighty, good, well-made piece of kit. And again, nicely packaged, nicely presented. There it is. Make sure to remove the various stickers which are protecting the sensors before you attempt to use it. Now then, what are these? These are four side brushes. The two need to be fitted and two of them can be kept as spares. And later on I'll show you how to fit them. Here's the remote control, which is a standard full-size remote. There's the spare HEPA filter. There's another one pre-fitted already. There's the charging station. There it is. It's nice and small and lightweight, but it seems pretty secure. It's got grippers on the base. There's the magnetic barrier. You put that in place and the Z50 will not attempt to go past it. There's the UK power supply, a standard 3-pin UK plug. And there's some batteries for the remote control. There's a little cleaning brush. Now what's in here? Here's the mopping tank rather. You can see there's one cloth mop pre-fitted and another included with it. So that one's pre-fitted, as you can see. And there's the other one. So you can just wash them and dry them between cleaning sessions. And yes, I think that's it. Now here's the main roller brush that just pulls free for cleaning and just clips nice and easily back in place. There are four side brushes included, two are spares, and they just clip in place and they're clearly marked left and right so you can't get it wrong. Now here's the dry cleaning bin. Inside there's a HEPA filter which is replaceable and the spare is included. There it is. Now here's the mopping bin with a one mop pre-fitted held in place by Velcro. There's a dry tank for debris that goes in place there, and make sure you replace it before you start cleaning. Here's the charging station, and you can see how the terminals on the underside of the Z50 line up with the charging points. Remove this cover on the charging station to reveal where the cable connects, and also the two handy lugs to take up any spare cable. Just wind it round. There we go. And the LEDs pulse red when it's charging and turn white when it's fully charged.
connected.
Alexa, start cleaning.
Cleaning start.
Alexa, stop cleaning.
Start recharge.
My current robot vacuum is the iRobot Roomba 895. It's getting a bit long in the tooth now, but still works well enough, and it comes from one of the market leaders in the field. I was keen to give this budget price newcomer a try, particularly since it incorporates some of the latest and most up-to-date vacuum technology. The Z50 vacuums on hard and carpeted floors and will also wipe clean suitable surfaces using the built-in water tank and mop. It can be operated with the supply remote control, using an app on your smartphone, or by voice with Alexa, Siri or Google. It's got a suction level of up to 3000 PA, which is pretty near the top end of the scale for robovacs. It connects by Wi-Fi to your router and can be fully integrated into your home ecosystem using the Tua Smart or Smart Life apps. Like all robovacs, it works best on hard, dry surfaces, and again, like all robovacs, it's not designed for deep cleaning work. This is not a Dyson. But it's best left to clean up the general dust and debris found on the floor at the end of the day. We set ours to run every morning on a timer. It starts up at 8 AM, scoops around the floor, picking up crumbs, fluff and dog hairs left from the previous day, and when done, returns to the charging base, ready for the next morning. The wet surface cleaning works well enough, but again, it's not designed for heavy duty work, but will give a nice shine to your bathroom or kitchen floor. It can also be operated manually using the remote control and set to clean or mop specific areas with a choice of three intensity levels. Compared to my old Roomba 895, this new one is more powerful, smarter, easier to use, and the current price is a bargain indeed.